हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप ऑल आर यू बेटर एंड डूइंग योर स्टडी वेल। नाउ टुडे हेयर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सेकंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ बायोट सावर्ट लॉ। एंड इन दिस एप्लीकेशन वी हैव टू डिटरमाइन द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी ड्यू टू अ स्ट्रेट इनफाइनाइट करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर। So here an infinite current carrying conductor is given to us and we have to determine the magnetic field intensity at point P due to this straight conductor. So let us consider P is our point at a distance small r from the length element dl and theta is the angle of the r of the length element dl and here this is the small a, this is the perpendicular distance of our point P at which we have to determine the magnetic field intensity at point P, and here the distance between the point O and the point M is small l. So here we have been supposed this angle is phi and here these angles are phi 1 and phi 2. This we had done. The angle between P and A is phi 2 and the angle between P and B is phi 1. In this way our conductor is of a finite length. In this way our current carrying conductor become a conductor of a finite length. But whenever we have to determine the electric field intensity, magnetic field intensity due to the infinite length, then we will put the value of phi 1 and phi 2, both will be 90 degree. If we will put phi 1 and phi 2 both 90 degree, then the length of our conductor become infinite. So now this is the consideration. Now here according to Biot-Savart's law, the value of a magnetic field intensity must be equal to dB mu naught over 4 pi I dl sin theta divided by r square. Now we have to put the value of dl, then sin theta and r square in the equation number first in terms of a phi 1 phi angle phi. Here the angle phi and the distance a. So now in our triangle MOP, you can see from here the triangle MOP, and now in triangle you can see from here the triangle MOP, and now in triangle MO and then P. So here we have to determine first the value of a phi. So here phi must be equal to phi and this theta must be equal to 90 degree, and then theta must be equal to 90 minus phi. If you will take sine both side, then it will become sine theta must be equal to sine theta must be equal to sine 90 minus phi, and you know sine 90 minus phi must be equal to cos phi, and it will become our equation number second. This we have done here 90 minus phi, and then sine phi become Now again in the same triangle MOP, you can see OM is the perpendicular and OP is the base. Here is our triangle, this is O, this is M and this is P, and here is the angle phi. So OM perpendicular by base must be equal to tan phi, and this we have been, suppose this length is L and this is small a, and therefore L must be equal to a tan phi, and after differentiating both side we will get a tan square phi. And now again in the same triangle, that is here, this is phi and this is our r, this distance is r and this is a, then r by a, which means, or this is o, this is m and this is p. Now this must be equal to op here, op by mp must be equal to cos phi, base upon hypotenuse must be equal to cos phi. This is op by mp must be equal to cos phi, and now by putting the value of a op and mp, that is a by r, and the value of r will be a by cos phi or a into secant phi. So here the value of r is a secant phi. Now putting all the values in our given equation, so here this is mu naught over 4 pi, and I, this is the value of dl we have been calculated there, and this is the value of r, and it will become r square. So here square of a cos square phi, and this is the value of sine theta in our given equation, mu naught over 4 pi I, this is the value of dl sine theta and r square divided by r square. So all the values are put in, have been put here. So after simplifying, cos square cancel out by the cos square, one the square of a is cancelled out by a, and then we will left with mu naught over mu naught I 4 pi a into cos phi. Now we can integrate within the limit phi 1 and phi 2, and can calculate the value of a magnetic field intensity within the given length. Here phi 1 is taken as negative because this angle is drawn here in downward direction. This angle is negative because it is drawn in downward, and this is phi 2 is positive because it is in upward. That's why phi 1 is taken as negative. Now after integration, the integration of a cos phi becomes sin phi, and now putting the limits of integration, that is upper limit minus lower limit, and it will become mu naught I 4 pi a sin phi 1 plus phi 2. And now but we have to determine here the magnetic field intensity due to infinite current carrying conductor. So to make it infinite, I have told phi 1 and phi 2 must be equal to 90 degree, and we know sin 90 and sin 90 become 1, and 1 and 1 become 2, and after simplifying we will get our final answer, that is 2 is cancelled out by the 4, and here the magnetic field intensity due to the infinite current carrying conductor must be equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi a. So this is the required expression for the magnetic field intensity due to the infinite current carrying conductor at a distance small a from, at a distance small a from it, which is the perpendicular distance of the given point. Thank you.